So Nikashi Wagi, I'm the writer, producer of the Grateful Crane Ensemble and the Camp Dance Show. And on behalf of all of us, welcome to the East West Players David Henry Wong Theater and the Camp Dance Show. Before we begin, I'm going to take a quick audience poll. How many of you have seen our show before? Oh, wow. Quite a few. How many have seen it more like 3 to 5 times? There are some. How many have seen it more than 5 times? Oh, that's my mom. Hi, Mom. She's going on her, I think this is the 9th time? Oh, this is the 10th time she's seen it. She's from San Francisco and she flew down just to be here today. So say hello to my mom, Sadako. Thank her for all she's done. She's fed us everywhere we've gone, and so really appreciate it. Thank you, Mom. She finally got a seat in the front row. She's been in the balcony for all the other 3 shows, but we finally got her in the front row. Okay, in just a minute, we're going to take you back some 60 years to the floor of the internment camp dance. But before we do that, I want to thank some people who made today's show possible, and the first is the East West Players, who allowed us to use this space, Tim Dang, Trent Steelman, Maggie Mamoto. Let's hear it for the East West Players. Thank you. All of us in the Grateful Crane Ensemble have worked with the East West Players in the past, so this is like a homecoming for us. Let's see, I also want to thank our volunteer ushers, the Fujimoto family, today. And Kaz Toyofuku, we'd like to thank her for coordinating all the tickets. Many of you talked to Kaz. So thank you, Kaz. Just wanted to introduce some guests we have here today. In the front row, we have Leslie Ito. She's the Executive Director of Visual Communications. Leslie, right here. And her grandparents are here. Mr. and Mrs. Tim Manaka. And we have some other family here. We have Daryl Kunitomi's father, Jack Kunitomi, in the front row. Hopefully he'll dance for you later. And Thelma will dance for you later. We also have Daryl's sisters right there. Hello. And we also have Lisa Jo's stepdad, Ken Okabe, and Lisa Jo's nephew, Bryce Dennis, right over there. We do a tribute to Sue Okabe, so that's going to be very nice. Let's see, in your program, time for a commercial break here, we've inserted a couple of flyers, and the first one is East West Players' new season coming up this fall. It's called New Perspectives. And there's going to be 3 world premieres in this season, as well as the return of the Nisei Widows Club. I don't know if any of you saw the Nisei Widows Club last year. They're coming back at Christmas time, and they're going to be singing Christmas songs. It's going to be happening right here, December 10th through 14th. So please support the East West Players. And the other thing I have is the Music of the Camp Dance CD we're going to be producing this summer, and it should be out in the fall. And it's going to be all the music from today's show and a couple of bonus tracks as well. So if you're interested in pre-ordering your copy, you could use this form right here. Okay. Some guest performers we have today. We have Brian and Michelle Fujimoto. Their family were the ushers today. And they're a Yonsei brother and sister from San Francisco, who are joining us as our swing dancers and tap dancers. Also from San Francisco, we have Merv Maruyama, who's a singer and actor. And he's going to be performing a couple of favorite Japanese songs. And of course, we have the songbird of Manzanar, Mary Kageyama Nomura. And she's going to be performing today. And if you haven't seen the beautiful article that was in the LA Times, check it out in the lobby. We have it blown up for you. That's it. Some administrative notes. We're going to be taking a 15-minute intermission. And if you're hungry or thirsty, want to get a cup of coffee, there's a Tokyo Cafe down in the courtyard. And let's see, please turn off your cell phones and pagers. And if you have that plastic wrap candy, please open it now, and not during the middle of the show. No flash photography. And that's it. Thank you again very much for being here, and enjoy the camp dance, the music, and the memory. Thank you. Thank you.
1942 and 1945 to a place you all remember as Can Dance.
All Tin Cans had dances, and as the days turned into months and the months turned into years, there would be dances to match your seasons in the sun.
Like the leap year matinee dance held on February 29th, 1944 at Park Mountain, Wyoming.
Or how about the Shamrock Jig from 6 to 10 on March 17th, 1944 on Muncie, Colorado?
Who could forget the Easter Social, the Halloween Hop, the Gobbler's Jig, and the Turkey Trot?
Or June Buggy to the big band sounds of the Music Makers at Poston, Arizona.
How about cutting the rug to the sound of the downbeats, playing hot jives like Beck Beat Boogie and 920 Special at Tulare Lake, California.
And then, at the end of the evening, they would turn the lights down low and play the last dance. For those shy guys, this was the last chance at...
romance. Excuse me, may I have a dance?
Gals will tell you that the guys were the ones who had the advantage. cross this invisible line you have.
And so the gals waited and talked. And the guys talked and talked. In high school, then and now, kids need to belong. And the kids that sponsor the games and the camp dances all that belong to clubs like the Single Painters.
Tux, they creep, come down, forget your care.
were being built, the government needed a place to house 120,000 people of Japanese ancestry. So they chose racetracks and fairgrounds across California and called them assembly centers.
Assembly centers were hastily built, poorly assembled camps, where people stayed for several months before moving on to camp. Thousands of people waited hours in line at the mess halls, where the special of the day was RBC rations from number 10 cans. Slimy spinach, overcooked string beans, blanched wieners, gray stews, and mushy corned beef hash.
The very first Assembly Center dance was called the Trots. Get it? The Trots.
Some of the 18,527 people at San Anita lived in barracks, and others, including entire families with little kids, were forced to live in horse stalls where the stench of horse manure never went away.
One family at San Anita actually thought they were something special.
How so?
Hey guys, did you hear the news? My family is living in Seabiscuit's stall. Can you believe it? Seabiscuit's stall.
But it's still a horse stall.
Oh, it's not just any stall. It's Seabiscuit's stall.
So does that mean your manure smells less than our manure?
Indeed, it's Seabiscuit's manure.
That's why, despite being imprisoned in horse stalls, or maybe because of it, the young people got out of their homes and went dancing.
On June 12, 1942, those at San Anita did a bunch of the sounds of the Starlight Serenaders in front of the racetrack's grandstands, outdoors, and under the stars.
Led by Yukio Miyamoto, the 12th Beast Band also played at the center's graduation ceremony, and several sayonara balls as people left Santa Anita for camp destinations unknown.
For most, the real dance was just beginning.
When I'm not playing solitaire, I take a book down from the shelf. And what with programs on the air, I keep pretty much to myself. Missed the Saturday dance. Heard they crowded the floor. Couldn't bear it without you. Don't get around much anymore. Thought I'd visit the club. Got as far as the door. They'd have asked me about you. Don't get around much anymore. So darling, I guess my mind's more at ease, but nevertheless, why stir up memories? Been invited on dates, might have gone, but what for? Awfully different without you. Don't get around much anymore. Don't get around much anymore. Don't get around much anymore.
Chance you had a rootin' tootin' fine time behind barbed wire.
we did was eat, sleep, and chase girls, said one former internee.
A camp full of girls.
And I can't get started with any of them.
Whoa, but we can sure look. Ooh, isn't she the cat's meow?
For many of the young, camp life was a lot of fun. But for all, life in camp left a lot to be desired.
Imagine a desert or swamp set out in the most desolate parts of America.
Then picture row after row of tar papered barracks, surrounded by barbed wire, with guards armed with machine guns facing the camp.
Add in 120 degree temperatures in Gila River, Arizona,
35 degrees below zero at Heart Mountain, Wyoming,
and blinding dust storms that would engulf every camp come up through the cracks of their floorboards and permeate their very souls.
Rattlesnakes, scorpions, mosquito bites. Summer camp, this was not.
And all in all, you can see why most folks simply say, hey, just trying to make the best of a bad situation.
In the beginning, all each barrack apartment had was a hanging light bulb, a pot-bellied stove, and metal cots with mattresses the internees themselves stuffed with straw.
Each block included a mess hall, a laundry room, a rec hall, and segregated showers and latrines. Now in the beginning, the biggest shock was walking into the latrine and finding a row of toilets with no partitions.
Hey,
Jim. Hey, Moss. Hence the name of the very first camp dance. Cheek to cheek, get it? Cheek to cheek.
Music and dance provided much needed sustenance for the young idealistic Nisei at camp.
Saturday nights at camps across America, Nisei boys and girls danced up their own storms. And dance bands like the Topaz Tutors and the Jive Bombers at Manador gave the people what they wanted. Swing tunes, ballads, and a swell time to remember.
To some Nisei, dancing was a waste time activity. But as George Yoshida says in his book, Reminiscing in Swing Time, dancing was a matter of survival and a subconscious affirmation of self, a way to express through music, I am an American.
Baby, who's gone with the strap? You take the army now, I'll go with Beverly.
My dream was to go to the Manzanar senior prom with Kunio Takano. There he is. Kunio was one swell guy, tall for an Issei, so sweet and handsome too. But Kunio liked Ruth, who was so pretty and popular. Oh, hi! But you know what? She had nothing up here.
I've never won anything in my entire life.
anything in my entire life!
Good note. So, there you have us. Me, my date, and a jar of hard candy. Swell, isn't it? After the prom, Yosh walked me back to my barracks, and all the way home, I kept wondering, what's he going to do with that jar of candy?
Good night, Harry. See you at school!
Can you believe it? The next morning.
My sister said I should have given this to you.
Thank you. Why? They would sing.
They would sing in the house.
They would sing in the fields as they worked.
And some Issei man, like my Jichun, would go eat
China meshi
with his men friends. And then after dinner, they would get up and
sing.
They loved to sing.
Some sang shi'im, others sang minyo.
They sang sad songs.
They sang love songs.
And during the war, they sang songs like the one we're about to present to you right now.
Set in old Japan, it's a song about
a wandering yakuza. He tells his wife he no longer loves her, even though he really does. It's for your own good, he tells her. My life is too dangerous. It's much safer for you if I am gone.
Dushki!
Forget about me! Move on with your life!
Nikolai!
No! You'll never know how much pain I am in, knowing that I still love you, but I must leave you. I am on a journey, and you, my love, are no longer a part of it! The wind hits the tears on my face, and it's cold. But I walk on and never look back. It's amazing! It's amazing! Here to sing this sad, sad song is a special guest whose parents both remember hearing it at the Post-it 2 and Minidoka camps. Singing Tsuman Koi Dochu, please present, please welcome, Bird Wanyama.
Crowded out. But as I became used to the surroundings,
and as the new experiences lost their exciting nature, that lonely feeling started seeping into me, until eventually my whole being was filled with it.
I thought I would go mad. I tried in vain to push this loneliness from me. I crammed my hours with continuous activity, so that there would not be a chance for that loneliness to enter my being and begin a steady flow through my veins.
I knew that I could not escape. So in desperation, I tried to thrust the very thought of you out of my mind. I immediately regretted that I had even tried to do such a thing. I felt that I had been unfaithful to you. You are a part of me. Without you, I would be nothing.
You're my first love, my last love, and all the loves in between. I worship you in spite of the errors you made. Yes, you've made mistakes. But if you've not made mistakes in order to learn what not to do, then you would not be what you are today. All I ask is that you do not make the same mistake twice. That is inexcusable, even in the eyes of one who loves you so.
It is impossible to express how much I have missed you. I have come close to insanity more than once, longing to hear your genuine laughter that comes right from your spacious and generous heart. To see that mischievous twinkle in your eye that displays your unmatchable sense of humor. And to walk hand in hand with you, holding my head high with pride overwhelming you.
I shall not have to wait very long for these things now, for I shall be with you within a few weeks. I am trying to revive the dormant little memories of you, which have had a long slumber in my subconscious mind.
I want to prepare myself for our momentous meeting after 2 long years of separation, so that I shall not disappoint you.
All my present prayers are that you will be as happy to have me back with you again as I shall be to be a part of you again.
I hope that your faith in me has grown since the last time I saw you. That faith must grow, for my faith in you to grow.
I shall impatiently be counting away the days until I can look straight into your unswerving eyes and feel the grip of your firm and steady hand as you greet me. Until that time, when we shall meet again. Au revoir.
Thank you. Us guys from Stockton, we don't dress like that. Hey,
I hear that L.A. boy stole that chain from the laundry room washtub.
I won't tell as long as you don't tell.
Hey, check out the L.A. boy. He's all show and no go. Allow me to show him what a Stockton boy can do.
Come on, Zoe.
Her voice and spirit brought smiles to so many hearts back then, and continues to do so today.
We are honored to present to you the Songbird of Manzanar, Mary Kageyama.
feel a sermon coming on me. The topic will be sin, and that's what I'm agin. If you wanna hear my story, well, settle back and just sit tight while I start reviewing the attitude of doing right. You got an accent, you hate the positive, eliminate the negative, I latch on to the affirmative, don't mess with Mr. In Between. Gotta spread joy up to the maximum, bring gloom down to the minimum. Have faith or pandemonium liable to walk upon the scene. To illustrate my last remark, Jonah in the whale, Noah in the ark. What did they do just when everything looked so dark? Man, they said you had a accent, you ate the positive, eliminate the negative, I latch on to the affirmative, don't mess with Mr. In Between. No, don't mess with Mr. In Between. Affirmative, don't mess with Mr. In Between. No, don't mess with Mr. In Between. No, don't you mess with Mr. In Between.
Fighting team that would go on to make history as the most decorated unit for its size and length of service in U.S. history. Allow me to explain. You see, you have the 100th Battalion boys from Hawaii, and...
What? Owe you money?
No, I was just explaining.
Yeah. Who do you think you are, talking like one stuck up honey? Hey, you think you're better than us?
Well, as a matter of fact...
As a matter of fact what?
Camp Shelby, Mississippi. Basic training for the one Puka Puka boys. And us mainland East Angel volunteered for the 442 right out of camp. As you can see, we didn't get along at first. Oh, sure, we are the same race. But culturally... Oh, the Hawaii boys like to sing and dance. They were loud and aggressive.
What? Bayou?
Yeah! Us mainland Nisei, we were quiet and reserved, which was often mistaken for aloof and
stuck up.
Put the two of us together, you got trouble right here in Mississippi.
Those got conks from the mainland. They speak this good English. And then they try to order us around like a plantation owner.
Hey, us boys from Hawaii.
We don't take nothing from nobody, so we fight.
Now, things got so bad, our commander had to read us all the riot act, but it didn't help. The infighting continued till someone had an idea. Let's give the Hawaii boys a taste of camp life. So they put them on a bus, and...
I'm just another Hawaiian and the homesick Latin boy. And I want to go back to my fishing port. I want to go back. Hey, we thought we were going to one summer camp or something.
But when the bus pulled in to Jerome, Arkansas, we saw these huge barbed wire fences and guard towers with machine guns turned facing the camp.
MPs with rifles and bayonets frisked us at the gate.
And they called it one relocation center. But we knew what it was.
And then we saw the people. Canes, Wahines, Kinkies. Everyone was there to give us one huge welcome party. Guess who we met? That kapunk we've been fighting? It was his two kid sisters. They were so nice to us.
They told us that the people of the camp saved the rations for 2 weeks so they could show this party for us. Can you believe that? They sacrificed the rations for us.
I couldn't believe it. I still can't believe it.
And then, after dinner, they had entertainment, music, and dancing. Oh,
the wahines and camp were all dolled up and showed us that Hawaii girls weren't the only ones with aloha spirit.
never forget that.
And the beautiful Wahine I danced with.
Back on the bus, no one sang, no one played the ukulele.
No one said a word the entire way back. I mean, we're from Hawaii. We didn't know nothing about camp. We didn't know nothing about discrimination. We saw with our own eyes what the Medline guys were up against.
All of us, I'm sure we were thinking, would we have volunteered out of a camp like that?
When the Hawaiian boys returned, they told all their buddies what they had seen. And after that, we didn't have any problems anymore. Camp our commander said the esprit de corps went from total animosity to complete friendship in an instant. And a team that went out to make history completely changed because of their one trip to Jerome and their small but memorable taste of the camp dance.
How slow.
10 years old, and it was my first Christmas in camp. My class was having a Christmas party, but I wasn't in the Christmas spirit, so I decided not to go. But my teacher insisted, so I went. At the party, we sang Christmas carols, we had cookies and punch. It was a swell time. And then Santa Claus made an appearance.
Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas!
He had gifts for everyone.
Merry Christmas!
Even me.
Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas!
The toy plane was swell, but it was this note that meant the most to me. Dear friend, it said, my name is Bobby Johnson, and I'm 12 years old. I just wanted to wish you a very Merry Christmas. All this time, I thought everyone in America didn't give a damn about us. And here's this note from this boy. He doesn't even know me. And all he wants to do is wish me a Merry Christmas. Someone out there was thinking of me. That to me was the greatest gift. And the Christmas I'll always remember.
Such a day. very dear friend. Nisei vocalist Su Takimoto Okabe. When she was only 13 years old, Su sang her heart out for the folks at the Minidoka Aiko camp. And throughout her life, she brought us so much joy and beauty just by singing a song. Su, we know you've heard this song before. This one's for you.
Yeah!
Brian, please, please ask Gracie to dance.
The last dance, also known as Sway and Smooch Time. It was the moment we've all been waiting for.
Jake, did you hear what I said? It's now or never. It's the last dance.
Ask Gracie yourself. I'm dancing with Sadie.
What?
You heard me.
It's now or never.
Let's go.
Excuse me, Gracie, but may I have this dance?
Excuse me, Sadie, may I have this dance?
True, but before you go, I just want to let you know I think you're one swell gal.
Thanks, Moss. You're not so bad yourself.
I have this dance.
May I have this dance?
How are we gonna dance without music?
Well, hit it, boys!
The little stars climb. Oh. heart. He wandered down the lane and far away, leaving me a song that would not die. Love is now the stardust of yesterday, the music of the years gone by. Sometimes I wonder why I spend the lonely night dreaming of a song. The melody haunts my reverie, and I am once again with you. When our love was new, and each kiss an inspiration. But that was long ago, now my consolation is in the stardust of a song. Beside a garden wall, where stars are bright, you are in my arms. The nightingale tells his fairy tale of paradise where roses bloom, though I dream in vain. Stardust melody, the memory of love's refrain.
Those high school dances so long ago.
You had a ball on the floor of the camp dance, and along the way you've made friends that have lasted a lifetime.
But for many others, camp was a miserable experience, and the pain from that experience has never gone away.
At the Japanese American National Museum, a Nisei woman was asked to list her favorite memories of Thule Lake, and she wrote,
"The birth of my second son."
Asked to list her worst memory, she wrote,
"Everything else."
Senator Sam Ervin called the mass incarceration of Japanese Americans the most disgraceful episode in American history.
But if there's a lesson to be learned, a lesson that we, the Sansei, can embrace and pass on to future generations, it's this. No matter how bad things got, you never gave up. You never gave in.
You found the courage, dignity, and strength to stand tall and made the absolute best out of a terrible situation.
You danced.
You laughed.
You lived.
You endured.
Always believing that better days lay ahead.
Well, your dream of better days is here and now. And we, your children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren, are living it.
I just want you to know how much we deeply appreciate the sacrifices and hardships you went through during camp.
And especially after camp, when the only jobs available to you were gardeners, domestics, dishwashers,
typists, chick sexers, and farm laborers.
The Issei used to say, "Kodomo no tame ni," for the sake of the children.
That is us.
It's a debt we cannot possibly repay.
But for the many miles you have walked before us,
For all the once closed doors you have opened for us to walk through freely.
We say to you simply and from our hearts, thank you. Thank you so very much.
Tonight, another night sends me dreaming.